In the last class, we had discussed how to derive transfer functions for electrical systems and mechanical systems. Today, we will try to derive the transfer function for an electromechanical system comprising a DC motor, an armature-controlled DC motor driving a mechanical load. And then we will also see what analogous systems are. Okay. Electromechanical system transfer functions. Fine. So as you can see here we have a DC motor, right? And which is coupled to a mechanical load, right? So this DC motor has two windings, one a field winding and second one an armature winding, right? So this field winding will produce the magnetic flux within which the armature is rotating, okay? Current within which the armature is rotating, fine. So this is coupled to the mechanical load through this shaft. And this mechanical load will be driven by the DC motor. DC motor finds applications in many different fields like robotic manipulators or tape transport system and so on. Robotic manipulators, tape transport mechanisms, disk drives, machine tools, etc. Right? So what are the attractive features of this thing for its wide use? High torque, what it is portable, well-behaved speed torque characteristics, and so on. Okay, so we'll look into the details. So it has, as I said before, it has an armature winding, it has a field winding. This armature winding has an armature resistance RA, an armature inductance LA, and since it is a motor, there will be a back EMF VB of T. Okay, EA of T is the applied armature voltage, right? That's the input voltage. Then here's the field winding which has fixed current flowing through that so that the magnetic flux is constant or fixed, right? So this motor is attached or coupled to the mechanical load through a shaft, and this mechanical load has an inertia JM and a viscous damping DM. Okay, so RA is the armature winding resistance, LA is the armature winding inductance, VB of T is the back EMF. So this motor will develop a motor torque, electrical torque, right? Which is proportional to the speed, d theta m by dt. Okay, so our aim is to find a transfer function between the output displacement, theta m of t, m of s, and the applied armature voltage, EA of s, okay? So let us see how we can derive that. Back EMF in a machine, in a DC motor is proportional to the speed. Okay, VB of T is equal to KB into d theta m by dt. So what is the Laplace transform? Laplace transform will be VB of S equals S times KB into theta m of S, right? Then, applied armature voltage EA of T must be equal to what? It must be equal to, so you can see here, RA into IA plus LA into dIA by dt plus VB of T, correct? That is what applied armature voltage supplies, all these elements. The drop in the resistance, drop in inductance, plus the back EMF. So you will get EA of T equal to RA into IA of T plus LA dA by dt plus VB of T. Or if you take the Laplace transform, what will you get? EA of S is equal to RA into IA of S plus LA into S into IA of S plus VB of S. That is equation 2, right? Now, the torque developed by the motor is proportional to the current flowing through it. Or when you take the Laplace transform, what will you get? You will get Tm of s equals kt into Ia of s. That is equation 3, right? Now, coming to the load torque. So the load is supposed to have an inertia J and a viscous friction, right? So you will get Jm into d square theta m by dt square plus dm into d theta m by dt. So what is the Laplace transform? It will be TL of S is equal to S into S square into JM theta M of S plus S into DM theta M of S. Okay, and that is what is shown here. S square JM theta M S plus S into DM theta M of S. Fine. Now what I will do, I will club all these terms together. So we are going to do some manipulation among all these four equations. Keep in mind, our aim is to find a transfer function between the output variable theta m of s and the input variable ea of s. Okay, so all other variables, VB of S, then IA of S, TM of S, etc. are intermediate variables which have to be eliminated. Fine. So from equation 3, what is IA of S, TM of S by KT? That I have written here, right? Then what is VB of S? SKB into theta M of S. So you can substitute these things into equation number 2, right? So IA of S is common. So RA plus SLA into IA of S. So instead of IA of S, I will write TM of S by KT like this, okay? Plus instead of VB of S, I will put SKB into theta M of S, right? So this will be equation 6, right? Now, this motor torque developed should supply the load torque and disturbance torque, if any, okay? So TD of S is the disturbance torque, right? So if TD of S is 0, then TM of S is equal to TL of S. The electrical torque developed by the motor will be equal to the mechanical torque or the load torque, correct? Now, if TD of S is equal to 0, then we get TM equal to TL, right? So it means what? Means from here, you can put TM is equal to TL. So instead of TL, you can put theta M of S into S square JM plus SDM. That can be substituted here. Okay. So that will be your next equation. Right? And so instead of TM, I have substituted S square JM plus SDM into theta M of S. Now you see our equation consists of the input variable E of S and the output variable theta M of S. Okay. So take theta M of S common. You will get theta M of S by E of S as KT by RA plus SLA into S square JM plus SDM plus KB KTS. Okay. If LA is very much less than RA, means what? The inductance can be neglected. So this term can be neglected. If that is the case, then your theta M by A becomes like this. KT divided by RA into blah, blah, blah. Okay. If you do some more simplification, this can be reduced down into the form of K by S into S plus alpha, okay? Where K is KT by RA plus JM and alpha is this constant, okay? So in this way, you can derive the transfer function for an electromechanical system, right? Now let us see how we can draw the block diagram for this. So this is VB of S equal to SKB into theta M of S. How will be the block diagram? It will be something like this, okay? The block gain is KM. So this must be VB of S and the input variable is theta M of S, okay? Theta M will go into the block to give an output VB of S, which is nothing but SKB into theta M of S. So that is what is shown here, right? Now, this here we have EA of S equal to RA IA of S plus SLA IA of S plus VB of S. How can we draw that? Keep in mind EA of S is the input voltage, okay? So here we will do some adjustment, some arrangement. I can write this as EA of S minus VB of S. Okay, that will be what? IA of S into RA plus SLA. Okay, or what will be my IA of S? IA of S will be EA of S minus VB of S into 1 divided by RA plus SLA. Okay, so EA of S minus VB of S. Okay. That is what you are seeing here. So here, this EA of S, this VB of S, that will be the input to this block. EA of S minus VB of S will be the input to the block with a gain 1 by RA plus SLA, right? So that you get an output IA of S. Now, the third equation is the motor torque equation, which is KT into IA of S. How can we represent that? KT is a simple gain, IA of S is the input variable, you get the output variable as TM of S. Fourth equation is that the electrical torque developed by the motor must supply both the load torque and the disturbance torque. So I can write TM of S equals TL of S plus TD of S. So that can be represented in this way. This is TM of S. If you subtract the disturbance torque, the resultant one will be the load torque or the mechanical torque. And finally, from here, what can we do? How can we draw this? So TL of S must be the input variable, TL of S. Output you have 1 divided by S square JM plus SDM. That must be your theta M of S. Okay, that is what is shown here. So what, instead of taking S square JM and SDM together, I have taken S common. So that means 1 by S into 1 by S JM plus DM. Okay. So this will be your output variable theta. Now these all five components have to be joined in a logical and sequential way, right? So our input is E of S. So this is the first part. Okay. So what's the output? IE of S. And that is the input that forms the input to the second block KT to give you what is DM of S. So you have to connect this thing at this point, right? Now we are standing at this point here, TM of S. Now you see TM of S must be added to minus TD of S to give TL of S. So at the tip of this point comes the summing point and these two signals, right? Now we are here standing at TL of S. What is TL of S? That should be the input of this, these two blocks. So this should come at the end of this thing. Are we done? Not yet. First block. So this is VB of S coming here from where? From theta M through SKB. So from theta M through SKB term, it will be appearing here like this. Okay. So this will give the armature control DC motor in a block diagram form. Input variable is E of S and output variable is theta M of S. Fine. Now, one more example we will take from a mechanical system. Write the equations of motion for the automobile and the wheel motion, assuming one dimensional vertical motion of one quarter of the car mass above one wheel. Hence, find the transfer function y of s by r of s, representing the vehicle response to bumps in the road. Okay, so this is called quarter car model. That means you are considering only 1/4 of the car or the vehicle, right? So this tire is connected to the vehicle body through a shock absorber, right? So how to model this? So you can assume that this represents the 1/4 of the passenger mass and the car mass, 1/4 of the total mass, right? So it is connected through this tire or the wheel. M1 represents the vehicle mass, wheel mass, right? M1 is the wheel mass. So this car is connected, vehicle is connected to the wheel through a shock absorber represented by the dashpot B, and through a suspension system represented by a spring constant Ks, right? Now this wheel, this tire is having a tire compressibility Kw, which is represented by another spring Kw, right? It is moving along a straight road. Suddenly a bump comes. What happens? We know there will be a jerk in the upward direction, right? So what will be that? How will you find that? For that, you have to draw the free body diagram. So as far as mass M1 is concerned, there will be a sudden upward force being applied. What will be that? It will be Kw into R minus X. What will be the reaction forces? They will be downwards. One is M1 X double dot, the downward direction. Ks into X minus Y, again downward, plus and B into X dot minus Y dot, again in the downward as shown here. Okay, so this will be the free body diagram. So what will be the overall force equation? M1 X double dot plus B into X dot minus Y dot plus Ks into X minus Y equal to Kw into R minus X. So take the Laplace transform and club X terms together, Y terms together. What will you get? So you will get S square M1 plus SB plus Ks. Then here there's an X term here correspond to KWX. When you take it to the left side, you will get plus Kw. Kw, okay, into X1 of S into X1 of S, X of S. Then other terms are always negative, off diagonal terms are always negative. So minus of SB plus KS equal to what? Equal to Kw into R of S. This will be the force equation in Laplace domain. That is what is written here. Now, if you consider mass M2, these are the reaction forces, and this will be the force equation. So, if you separate out X terms and Y terms together, what will you get? You take X terms, it will be always negative, minus Ks, then plus B into S, into X of S, plus what will be the Y terms? S square M2 plus Ks plus S into B into Y of S equal to 0. Right? That is what is shown here. Now you can have it in a matrix form, right? So we have two equations which are expressed in matrix form. Now, what's the equation? What's the question? Question is to find what is y of s divided by r of s. How can you find y of s? So, what is y of s can be found by this delta 2 of s divided by delta of s. Okay, delta 2 of s divided by delta of s. Right? So, this means, now how will you find delta? Delta means this determinant. This determinant. This is what is delta. What will be delta 2? Second column replaced with the force vector. Right? So, when you do that, you will get this final expression y of s by r of s equals this thing. So, it will be a fourth order equation as shown here. Right? Fourth order equation. Now, next concept is what is called analogous systems. So, this is a simple for mass spring dashboard system. Right? What will be the force equation? It will be ms square plus, or in differential form, what will be that? M into d square x by dt square plus k into x plus fv into dx by dt equal to f of t. Right? So when you take the Laplace transform, you get ms square plus fv into s plus k into x of s equal to f of s. So in terms of velocity, what will be the equation? We know velocity v of t is dx by dt. Okay? So in terms of velocity, you will get ms plus fv plus k by s into v of s. What is v of s? It is the linear displacement. Okay? Equal to f of s. Now you consider an electrical RC circuit like this. Okay? E of t is the applied voltage. So this is a closed path. How can you write the governing equation? By KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. So what will you get? E of t equals L into di by dt plus R into I plus 1 by C integral I dt. Okay, take the Laplace transform, what will you get? E of s equals S L plus R plus 1 by C S into I of s. Okay, as seen here. Okay, E of s equals L of s plus R plus 1 by C S into I of s. Right? Now, you can see here that they are, so one is a mechanical system and the other one is an electrical system, right? But mathematically, they are one and the same. Here you have MS term, there's an L into S. There's a constant FV, there is a resistance R. There's an integral term, K by S, here we have 1 by CS, okay? So for a computer, if you give in M, FV, K, or L, R, 1 by C, it cannot differentiate whether it is mechanical or whether it's an electrical system, okay? Such systems which are mechanically different or which are physically different but mathematically the same, such systems are called analogous systems. Analogous systems. Okay, they are physically different but mathematically the same. Okay, such systems are called analogous systems. So here, if you compare these two, force is being compared with voltage. So you see here, each and every force term corresponds to a voltage term. That's why it is called force voltage analogy. Okay, force is being compared with the voltage term. Or in other words, you can, instead of having a physical mass spring and dashboard, you can have an electrical network wherein there is a voltage source E whose value is equal to the applied force. Okay? Here, F of t is the applied force. Here, there's a voltage source here. So, instead of having a mechanical system comprising a mass, spring, and dashboard, you can have an electrical RC network where the applied voltage E of t is equal to F of t. E of t is analogous to F of t. E of t is analogous to F of t. L is analogous to M. R is analogous to FV, the damping. And C is analogous to 1 by K. Okay. So we can have an electrical network with these inductance value correspond to the mass, resistance corresponding to dashboard, and capacitance corresponding to 1 by K. So in this way, force is compared with the voltage equation. So you get what is called force voltage analogy. Now you consider the same mass spring dashboard mechanical system. Now you consider a parallel RC circuit. Okay. So the I of t is the current source. So what happens? Here current will come. This is a node. Current starts splitting. Let this current be IC. This current is IR and this current is IL. Okay. So as per Kirchhoff's current law, I of t must be equal to what? Currents leaving. IC plus IR plus IL. Okay. What's the potential? It is E of t. And we know in a parallel circuit, the potential remains constant. Right. So what is the current through the capacitance? What is the voltage across capacitance? V is 1 by C integral IDT. Okay. So you multiply C into V must be what? Integral IDT. Or differentiate both sides. You get C into dV equals IDT. Or what is I? I will be C into dV by dT. Okay. So here potential is E of T. So you can write C into dE by dT. Plus, what's the current through resistance? E of t by R. And what will be the current through inductance? It will be 1 by L integral E dt. Okay. So when you take the Laplace transform, what will you get? You will get SC plus 1 by R plus 1 by LS into E of S equal to F of S, equal to I of S, the current. Okay, as shown here, right? So here you can see when you do a comparison, force is analogous to a current, right? So each and every force term in this mechanical system is being compared with a current term. These are all current terms. This is the current flowing through capacitance, current through the resistance, and current through an inductance. Okay, in which case we get what is called a force current analogy, right? So that means instead of having a physical mechanical system like this, physically in your lab, you can have an equivalent electrical system wherein C is analogous to M, R is analogous to 1 by FV, and L is analogous to 1 by K. Current I of T is analogous to F of T, and the potential E of T is analogous to linear velocity V of T, like as shown. Okay. We will try one question and then we will stop for the day. So obtain the force voltage and force current analogy of the mechanical system given below. Okay. So we have already seen this exam in the last class. What will be the force equation for mass m1 d square x1 by dt square plus k1 into x1 of t plus fv1 into dx1 by dt plus fv3 into d by dt of x1 t minus x2 t plus k2 into x1 minus x2 t, right? These are in terms of linear displacement x1, but we must have in terms of velocity, linear velocity, okay? Because if you remember, when we compared force voltage analogy, velocity was analogous to the current. Okay, so it should be written in terms of velocity, right? And we know velocity v1 is nothing but dx1 by dt. Okay, so instead of m1 d square x1 by dt square, we can write m1 dv1 by dt plus blah blah blah. Okay, so this is for mass m1. Now coming to mass m2, what will be the force equation? There is no applied force. 0 equal to what? Reaction forces. M2 d square x2 by dt square plus k3 into x2t plus fv2 into dx2 by dt, dx2t by dt plus fv3 into dx2t by dt minus dx1t by dt plus k2 into x2t minus x1t. Okay? Or in terms of velocity, you will get like this, because we know v2 is nothing but dx2 by dt. Fine. So this becomes v2 into dv2 by dt plus fv2 into v2t plus k3 into integral v2t dt and so on. Okay. So now we have these force equations. Okay. So m1 is analogous to what? M1 is analogous to L1, right? So straight away you can write L1 di1 by dt plus r1 i1 plus 1 by c1 integral i1 t dt. Okay, straight away you can write that. So what K1 becomes analogous to 1 by C1 into integral I1 T dt plus R3, FV3 is analogous to R3 into I1t minus I2t, and so on. Similarly, the second equation, force equation, will get translated into this corresponding electrical equation. Okay. So here there is a mistake here. This should be C2. This should be C2, not C1. So now you see we have the corresponding electrical equations of the given mechanical network. Now how can we draw the electrical circuit? If you observe L1, R1, C1, what's the current through L1, R1, C1? It is I1. When can current be the same in three elements if they are connected in series? That means L1, R1 and C1 must be in series. L1, R1 and C1 are in series, right? So that current through them is I1 of t, right? Now you look at the second equation, L2, R2, C3. What are the currents through them? They are I2. They are same. That means L2, R2 and C3 should be again in series. So here we have L2, R2 and C3. L2, R2 and C3. They are in series. So that current flowing through them is I2 of t, right? Now you see here, current through R3, what is that? I1 minus I2. Current through C2, what is that? I1 minus I2. Means what? They should be in series. R3 and C2 must be in series. So that current flowing through them is I1 minus I2. How can we connect them in series so that current flowing through R3 and C2 are I1 minus I2? It should be connected here, like this. Correct. Then only current difference, I1 is from top to bottom, I2 is from bottom to top, opposite. Okay. Then only current through this thing will be same. R3 and C2 will be the same. Okay. Now, if you see the second equation, there are no more terms to be plugged in. But if you see the first equation, there is something more. What is that? It is the voltage source E of t. So this is the voltage source E of t. Okay. E of t is analogous to F of t. L1 is analogous to M1. That is what is shown here. This is analogous to E of t. This is analogous to L1. This is analogous to R1. This is analogous to C1, and so on. R3, C3, sorry, C2, L2, C3, analogous to R2. V1 is analogous to what? I1 of t. And V2 is analogous to I2 of t. This is what is how to obtain the force voltage analogy. Fine. Now, how to obtain the force current analogy? So in force current analogy, the force terms are compared with the respective current terms. Okay, mass is analogous to capacitor, right? So it will be C1 into what? C1 into dE1 by dt plus damper is analogous to 1 by R1 and so on. Okay, so in each term you will get like this. Okay, similarly for mass 2, you will have this term, right? Now how will we obtain the corresponding electrical network? C1, what's the potential across C1? It is E1. Across R1, E1. Across L1, again E1. Means what? C1, R1 and L1 are in parallel, because only in a parallel circuit potential difference or voltage will be the same. Okay, so I will mark this as E1. Let me mark this as node 1 whose potential is E1 of t. Okay, so I should connect C1, I should connect R1, and I should connect an inductance L1. Okay, so this is C1, this is R1, and this is L1. This should be L2, huh? This is a mistake. Okay, then what's the potential across C2? It is E2. R2, again E2. And across L3, again E2. That means what? There should be another node whose potential is E2 of t, to which these elements are connected. So this is C2. This is R2 and this is L3. Okay, now what next? See, across R3, what's the potential? It is E1 minus E2. Across L2, what's the potential? Again, it is E1 minus E2. Means what? R3 and L2 must be in series? No, they should be in parallel, because only in a parallel circuit, voltage will be the same. If you connect them in series, current will be the same, not the voltage. Okay, so it means that L2 and R3 must be in parallel and they should be connected across nodes 1 and 2 like this. This is L2 and this is R3. Are we done? Not yet. See, there's one term left out, which is E of T. Sorry, not E of T. This should be I of T. Okay. This is a mistake actually. It's force compared with current I of T. Okay. So here there must be another current source. I of T. Okay. You please correct this. Huh? This is not E of T. This should be I of T. In force current analogy, it is analogous to current I of T. I of T. Okay, this is the correction here, right? So that is and that is what is shown here, right? So we will stop here and meet again for another lesson. Thank you.